Welcome to my channel. Today I've got a more elaborate, or at least more complicated, look well complicated. It requires a bit of skill because we're gonna go do a cut crease with eyeliner and huge eyelashes. I don't know, I wanted to do something that was both summer but also already heading into autumn, I guess. It made sense in my head. But yeah, this is what we ended up with, so let's get started. And as usual, I'm just starting off with priming my eyelids. Today I just want to go for something with a more natural base. I'm going to use the Catrice Neon Earth Palette. I just smacked my microphone, oops. Anyway, I don't know, like I just wanted to go for sort of more of a budget theme today. Budget, affordable at least. So most of what I'm going to use is Catrice and also some NYX, the eyeliner specifically. But yeah, everything I'll use will be below in the video description. And of course, you don't need to use the same products as I do. Just use similar colors and you will probably get similar results. So, first step is going to be this. Well, first step other than the primer we just applied. I'm going in with a dense brush, dense blending brush, and a... what I call a wearable orange. It's not a bold, bright, rainbowy... oh my god, neon orange. It's more of a warm, well, orange is mostly warm. Orange is a warm color. I'm not making any sense. Point being, I'm going for an orange shade that is not too neon, but instead a little bit darker, more muted, yet vibrant enough to still be orange. It looks like this. That's really just the best explanation I can give. It fits with my shirt. I don't know. Maybe I'm just going for a bit of a transition look between summer and autumn. This is a summer shirt. But anyway, more in autumn colors for some reason. Anyway, I'm ready for autumn. I love autumn, so yeah. And also, autumn colors just suit me well. I don't know, like I like summer, but like for a week. And after that I'm like, yeah, I'm quite ready for autumn again. You know, no more like sweating all day long, every day. The entire day. I don't like sweating. It's sticky, it's annoying, it's... ugh. Like, really, I'm thankful for being a human being and being capable of sweating to cool myself down, but I just don't like sweating. I don't. Then again, I don't really think there's many people who really enjoy it. Except maybe people who go to saunas. I don't know. Anyway, I don't like sweating, so I'm glad we're almost in autumn here. That has nothing to do with the eyeshadow, though. I'm basically just applying this shade all into the crease and blending it upwards. I'm not starting with a transition shade because all these colors are just easy enough to blend with my skin that I don't really feel like I need to apply 500 layers of eyeshadow to get it to blend. Just work on it a little bit harder, then it will also blend just fine. Now I'm going to go in with a tinier brush and a darker shade. More of a natural... reddish shade is what I like about this palette, really. Like, all the shades are, like, they're warm, so they're right up my alley. But they're, like, they're natural. Like, they have, like, well, it's called Neon Earth. Surprisingly enough, they have earthly tones, so they're just really, really easy to blend into the skin just because they have very natural shades. The undertones feel very natural. So yeah, like you can do like a very heavy look with it, but it still somehow looks natural just because the colors really blend into the skin very nicely. Anyway, I'm just blending this not further than where the orange is, because I don't want to like completely cover that. Like, I don't want to make everything too dark. I am going to add a little bit on the inner corner here as well, because I am going to do a cut crease, and otherwise I know I'm just going to end up again, as usual, with an angled brush to make an extra line there, because I always want there to be a contrast everywhere. I don't want just paleness and then cut crease. I really want it to be darker and then pale cut crease. Like, I like contrast in my looks. So I'm just pretty much making a line, just guesstimating where I'm going to put said cut crease. And of course making sure everything is nice and blended. Also, by the way, one thing I always like doing is to just make a little bit of a... I don't know, like I almost make it part of the nose contour, just blending it inner corner here into the eyebrow. I don't know, I just like how it looks. It makes my face look more like sharp, angular. If you want a softer look, then of course you can just not do that, of course. But yeah, I just like the result of it. Anyway, I'm just going to go for my brow bone highlight now with a nude shade, a matte nude shade on a short stumpers. Now it's time to add the actual cut crease. For that I'm just using a brush and a Catrice liquid metal. If you want to go the more expensive route, then you could use a Stila product, because I think they had like the original liquid metal stuff eyeshadow thing. That was a very clear explanation, I know. Anyway, but the Catrice stuff, in my opinion, works really well. I can't say it works just as well, because I've admittedly never tried the Stila stuff. But the Catrice stuff does work well, and it is very cheap, so that's good. But anyway, I'm just going to do a cut crease, obviously. One thing, if you're doing a cut crease, try to just look up every now and then while you're doing it, so that you're sure that it's like high enough that you can still see it with your eyes open. Because otherwise it's a bit of a wasted effort, really. And I'm just going to make a little bit of a wing of it. Also, by the way, for those of you who remember, I was learning German via the Duolingo app. Not sponsored. Just something I enjoy using. I'm done with that now. I'm not fluent yet in German, obviously, but I'm now watching German horror movies to learn German better. I've at least learned a lot more cuss words by now. And I'm using Duolingo to learn French. Which for some reason somehow feels easier than German. The only thing is, like, it's so random, and it's like in Dutch it's the same thing. But like in Dutch, I am Dutch, so I'm used to it, so you don't think about it anymore. But it's so completely random what words are female and what words are male. Like for example, in German, bird is a male word. So like it's, you know, a different word that you use before it. You know, when it's a female word, like duck. Bird is a male word, duck is a female word. And for example, in French, a croissant, that's a male word. And for some reason, a pizza is female. And it's so completely random. Like, and it's the same thing in Dutch, but like I said, I am Dutch, so then you don't notice it. But in other languages, you shouldn't start to realize how completely difficult it must be for, you know, anyone learning a language to try and figure out what words are male and what words are female. Because why is a pizza female? What is female about a pizza? I have no idea. I also don't know what is male about a croissant. Like, I have no idea. It's completely random. Like, who even came up with those language rules? It's a fun challenge, but it's there's really not a lot of logic to it sometimes. Just switching over to a darker, more glittery cream eyeshadow to make the outer part of the cut crease a little bit darker. But anyway, I think what's easier about French and about German, to me at least, is the fact that, like, the way certain words change depending on the sentence, it just feels easier in French than in German, because in German it's so complicated. Like, it's really, 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 really complicated to me. Whereas in French, most words just sort of stay the same. And otherwise, there is more logic to it, I feel. But yeah, really, honestly, I'm not all that worried about my grammar. I want to learn it as best as I can. But the reason I want to learn more languages is not because I want to do, like, business meetings in other languages. Or, like, try to get a job abroad. No, it's just because I want to be able to talk the language when I'm somewhere on vacation, as soon as we can go on vacation again. So, yeah, you know, like, and as a tourist, like, no one is really going to care all that much, you know, if your grammar is absolutely perfect, as long as you can just, you know, talk to people and then actually understand what you mean. Like, that's the whole point. Now it's time for eyeliner. It won't go completely smooth, probably. Gotta warn you about that, because, like, with a cream eyeshadow, you might want to apply it as thin as you possibly can, because it's going to dry a bit harder. So it's not going to look completely smooth with the eyeliner on top of it, simply because the eyeliner is not going to lay completely smooth because the base beneath it is more wrinkly. I feel like that explanation was a lot more difficult than it needed to be. But yeah, that's the point. Don't beat yourself up over it if your eyeliner doesn't go completely and utterly smooth over top of a cream eyeshadow. That's basically the point. I'm just going to go for quite a dramatic wing, and I'm going to add falsies later on, so I'm not going to be worried if the edges of my eyeliner aren't the absolute smoothest thing in the entire world. What does seem to help for me is to use an eyeliner pen, by the way, instead of a regular liquid liner. Just because it gives me a huge amount of control, so I can just go over it like 50,000 times until I'm finally pleased with it, which can be both a blessing and a curse. I mean, I'll just straight up admit I was going to go for a small wing. And then the other eye happened, so now we're going to go for a big wing. That's just how life goes sometimes. Yeah, long story short, just apply an eyeliner. Now, I think I'm just done with the eyes for now. So I'm just going to apply a little bit of concealer in my inner corners, then foundation, then more concealer. And I think I'll then come back to you to actually continue everything. See you in a second. Now, that's done. My eyebrows I'm going to keep natural. I hope you can tell. I've already done this side. And the way I do that is simply with a brow pomade. And I do fill in, or at least draw a line at the bottom edge here, at the tail. Just because I do actually want that part to be, you know, like I always wipe the product in the inside of the lid of the pomade, by the way, to have it a bit thinner. But anyway, I do want this to be sharp. But then other than that, I'm just really going to do hair strokes upwards. And just not be too picky about it, not be too dramatic about it, just fill them in. I don't know, like my face base routine has been the same for like, or at least relatively the same for ages. But with my eyebrows, it changes so fast how I like them, you know, like it's... I remember years ago, don't look it up on my Instagram to seek evidence, but I used to do them so incredibly thin, like it looked quite bad in hindsight, but I didn't think so then because I just wanted them to be extremely thin and yeah. Then there was this period, I think we've all had it, where it was like Insta brow perfect and like completely drawn in, almost Sharpie-ish. And now I'm more into more natural brows, I guess. And have completely lost track of what the actual eyebrow trend is, I suppose. I don't know, like I just want to sort of loosely fill them in and not make it too much of a thing. Just quick and easy. Now for contour, I'm just using another Catrice product. Why does the sun keep coming out? How dare it. Anyway, I'm just going to do this quick and easy, just with a fan brush, because I don't know, I'm going for glam but wearable and not for like full on, you know, really, really contoured, I guess. But yeah, I do want to have some shape to my face, so I'm just going to do that real quick. And then to stick to the mostly Catrice theme, see now the sun is gone again, it's so annoying. Anyway, I'm just using a slightly shimmery peachy Catrice blush. Completely peachy, slightly shimmery. But yeah, this is just gonna make the face a little bit less matte. Then a shimmery white gold-ish Catrice highlighter, and then we can finally move back to the eyeballs. Now, for the under eyes, I'm going to go into a small blending brush. I don't know why I had to think about that word. Anyway, and the orange shade from all the way at the beginning, and I'm just applying it mostly at the outer corner, just very, very lightly. And just blending it inwards. Always try to look up while you do this, by the way, because it just makes sure that the skin there is nice and tight. So you don't get weird wrinkles in it. And then just the blending brush, the large blending brush, clean and all. And with that I'm just going to blend it out. I really just want a bit of a orange shadow beneath there and not like a full on smoky moment. Just subtle. Yeah, that's nice enough. Then for the inner corner, I'm going to use a white gold eyeshadow, because there is one in this palette anyway. Alternatively, you could use your face highlighter as well, really doesn't matter. This one is just a little bit brighter, and I just love a bright inner corner. Now, for the waterline, after trying to decide for like 10 million hours, I'm going to go for dark. Unfortunately, I don't actually have a budget brown eye pencil, so I'm just using an absolutely ancient one that I probably shouldn't still be using because it's really, really old, by Estee Lauder. Okay, for lashes, I decided to go for Panther, which is by Exo Beauty, which are pretty nicely flared out. Not if you apply them without glue awkwardly. But yeah, I'm just gonna apply them properly. So this is before. And here is the after. Now just some mascara and the eyeballs are done. Then the lips. I want to go for more classic shade. And I haven't gone for orange. Red-ish orange in ages. I'm going to use one by Catrice, which is very moisturizing, which I like, but it's not completely 100% opaque. So I'm going to use a lip liner first, just around the edges of my lips, to make them a bit more defined. And that leaves us with the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my tutorials, you can always subscribe to my channel. Yeah, the look itself, I feel like it turned out glam, but still wearable. The colors are quite natural, of course. And like, I don't know, like everything just sort of works together to look not necessarily natural, but like glam natural. It's a wearable look in my opinion at any rate. But yeah, I hope this tutorial was useful. Other than that, thank you very much for watching it at any rate. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!